So here it is, and so far so good. Every day since the big chop, I've been loving it more and more. It's easy, just get up and go. And I've been on YouTube looking at all the different videos and just trying to find out what products are the best, but there's so many different textures of hair that you don't know what'll work for you. So you really, it all boils down to you finding out what works best for your hair. And my hair is grown a little bit since you seen it last. I can't wait for it to grow some more. One thing I've been experiencing that I'm not quite happy about is it gets dry so fast. And I'm in Maryland now. Shout out to Dallas, Texas, my hometown. But up here in Maryland, it's like super cold. And so I have to like co-wash my hair every day, it seems like, or every other day. So what I co-wash my hair with, I use Suave Naturals Tropical Coconut. I saw somebody suggested that on the tube, so I tried it. Before that, I was using Pantene Natural and Relaxed, which it was working fine. I just wanted to try something else and see if it made it any better or any softer. And I'm pretty much getting the same results. I've been wanting to try the Giovanni conditioner. I've heard it's really good, and it leaves your hair soft and moisturized, so that'll probably be the next conditioner I try. But this is pretty good, and it's cheap. It was like 99 cents, so that's always a plus. I probably wash my hair once every 2 weeks. It just depends on it, how much build up or whatever I have in my hair, if I've been using a lot of different products or whatever, trying new products. But I wash it with Cream of Nature. I've always used Cream of Nature, even when I had perm in my hair. It just works for me. I probably will try another shampoo just to see what's up. So if you have any suggestions on some good shampoos, please comment and let me know the best thing I should try out next, because I will use the rest of this bottle. I can't afford to waste. This is $10. I can't afford to just not use it just because. So after that, when I got the shower, I leave it wet, and I usually put some olive oil in it. I don't know if I was supposed to get extra virgin olive oil, but I did on accident. I meant to get just virgin olive oil, but I don't know what difference it makes. But just a natural product. My husband keeps messing with me, talking about I'm still putting chemicals in my hair, but this is not a chemical. This is a natural, product here. You know, shea butter and all that type of stuff. But maybe I'm just not using harsh chemicals, I should say. Also, someone recommended that I use Cantu shea butter. So I use that just about every day. When I wake up in the morning, my hair is really dry. I wet it with some water, and then I put some shea butter in my hair, and I brush it real good to stimulate some hair growth. And that's about it. Also, sometimes when I get out the shower after a wash, instead of using that, I might use this castor oil. It smells so good. Castor oil with mink oil. It has mink oil, sweet almond oil, jojoba oil. I don't know what that is, but it sounds like it's good. But got this at CVS, and I've been hearing a lot of good stuff about it, how it grows your hair pretty fast. And I put it on my scalp and just massage it in real good, and on my edges, because my edges is kind of struggling growing. But I think that perm kind of did something to it. But we'll see how it grows my hair. I just started using that. I've been using that for about a week now. But those are the pretty much. I mean, there's not much I can do with this right now till it grows out. But my cousin, shout out to Ashley. My cousin sending me some natural products. She sending me some kinky curly custard. So I'm excited to see what that's gonna do, what that's talking about, and some other stuff, some olive oil conditioner I saw that she was gonna send me. So probably the next update, I'll let you know how all those products that she sent me works. Other than that, I have really, really embraced my new hair, my new journey, and it's really interesting watching my real hair grow out of my scalp, because I've never seen it before. I mean, I haven't seen it since I was 5 years old, so I never knew what my hair really looked like without a perm, without a relaxer. So I like waking up every day just to see, you know, well, not every day, because you can't tell every day, but, you know, from week to week, I notice a change or some growth or, you know, something new and interesting about my hair. One thing I want to say, some people saw my big chop video I posted on Facebook, and a lot of my friends and family members were concerned that I had came to Maryland and lost my mind. I just want to say, no, I did not lose my mind. I've been wanting to go natural for a long time. I decided to go the big chop route instead of transitioning, because I've tried transitioning two times before, and I always punked out when, you know, if I had kinky twists or something, they took it out. It was just so nappy. I didn't feel like dealing with the two textures. So my husband basically was just like, skip that. Let's just do it. So I just did it. I didn't lose. I'm not going through nothing. I'm not going crazy or anything. So just want to clear that up for anybody that was concerned. I got a few text messages that, you know, people were concerned. I got a lot of support, and I want to shout out to all the people that, you know, were very supportive, encouraging, and excited about me starting this journey, that, you know, kind of know a little bit about, you know, people going natural. But the people that, you know, thought I was going through some kind of crisis or something, it's so not so not about that. Yeah, my mom, she's accepted it, and she's happy, and every time I talk to her, she says, so how's your hair? It's fine, it's growing the way it's God intended. So, you know, I appreciate your concern, but nothing is wrong. I didn't get married and move away from all the people and and go crazy. So please get that at your head. Anyway, I just wanted to give a quick update and hope that everyone's doing well. Oh, if you are my Facebook friend, you probably already know about my new blog, quityourrecordzone.blogspot.com. But for my YouTube subscribers, I also want to share with you that I have a new blog. If you are a fan of music, a fan of good music, a fan of real music, I started a blog recently called Put Your Records On. Put Your Records On. And it's pretty cool. I want you to go check it out at putyourrecordson.blogspot.com and, you know, participate, comment, check out the videos, the new music, the old music, digging in the crates, spotlights, highlights, all that good stuff. I like to dig up, you know, the good classics. So if you're anything like me and into soul music, real hip-hop, all that type of stuff, please check it out and follow me. Also subscribe to my YouTube channel, and also follow me on Twitter at The Real Chill, The Real, R-E-E-L, like demo reel, and holler at me. Alright, this has been a Natural Journey update, and see you soon. Peace.